Hi, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to DreamHack Stockholm, the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Tournament that will finish tomorrow in Globe Arena here in Stockholm, man. It's going to be a thing of beauty. And these teams, right now, in Group A, the deciding match to see who's going to make it into the semifinals there tomorrow.
I'm pretty excited, especially because it's either not going to be NiP or it's not going to be Titan. I don't actually know which is worse. I mean, you know, Titan would be a pretty good start for the newly formed lineup. Mm-hmm. Just, you know, beating NiP on land, going to play in front of a large audience, that'd be really exciting for them. At the same time, NiP, I mean, they're on home turf here. They can't not make it to Globe, and that would be a tragedy. I mean, it really would be.
Trying to think of the last time they weren't in a finals in Sweden.
I don't know. Long time ago.
Yeah, long time ago. We're on Swedish territory, in Swedish territory right now. And yeah, it doesn't come to memory like the last time that NiP weren't in a finals in Sweden. So if they were to get knocked out in a group phase, if they couldn't make it through to the playoffs and the semis tomorrow, that would be a humongous upset.
Yeah. It really would be. Well, we see them setting up here, the NiP players. They're playing right now over at Inferno Online, the LAN center. It's only tomorrow we're going to Globen. But, you know, NiP really used to being in this LAN center. They have their own room and everything.
Oh, yeah.
And you see the fans behind them as well, gathering up.
I see the NiP branded chairs as well, man. Those look comfy.
Show-offs, right? Where's the Room on Fire branded chairs, Summer?
Soon. Soon.
Oh, man. You hope, man.
I hope. I would love to have that and just like roll around the office with the Room on Fire chair.
You wouldn't be walking anywhere, you'd just be rolling it.
Yeah, I would put like a little electric motor on it, and I'm just gonna just like, you know, have a little command and just go around the office and like, what's up? Mm. Yeah.
All right.
That's right.
Well, look, they're gonna be playing against Titan. With the new lineup, they lost to LDLC, and LDLC ended up going on to beating NiP, so I guess Titan are gonna be feeling like a little bit better about that.
They are.
But at the same time, I mean, I don't know.
LDLC are the team that have looked the best so far throughout this group phase. They looked a little shaky versus Titan, but that's because of all the emotional tension that is there between both of those teams. Yeah. I mean, national rivalry, they all know each other so well, but also, as NBK said, this match is going to prove who made the right choice. Whoa, that's a statement right there. So LDLC, they take Titan, and then they go on to take first seed by destroying NiP. So there's so much here on the line between these two teams. Titan and NiP, they've both lost to LDLC already. They both struggled versus Alternate, and now they have to face off against each other. It's so tough to call who's actually going to come out ahead here, and the map is going to be Dust 2. And this is a map that NiP have actually struggled on recently. They said that they have to go back to the drawing board on it.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, this is a strange map, I think, for NiP. Mm. I can't really say, because I feel like even when they win on Dust 2, and they sort of do that regularly, but I still am never really sure why they end up winning it. Like, mm-hmm. it's not like they win it because they have, like, a particularly cool setup that they run, and it's like it works. They just win it because, I don't know, they kill more people, I suppose. It's down to, like, pure fragging ability.
Makes kind of a lot of sense. Yeah. Kefaren is actually quite good with the AWP on Dust 2, so there is that to take into consideration. Yeah. The real question is whether Forrest and Getright are going to play up to the usual standards. Because on their first map today, Alternate, you know, they were top fragging for NiP, and we're thinking, okay, all's well in the NiP world, right? But then versus LDLC, they were nowhere to be found. Freiburg actually didn't even show up in that match.
I was going to say, actually, the guy that I'm looking forward to here more than anyone is Freiburg. Mm. I think Freiburg is an amazing player. So just for him to step it up, come alive here in this match, that could be enough.
Well, NiP are the team that never seem to be able to give up. They don't know the word. They don't know the definition. Basically, it's all about the win, the big W for these guys. So Freiburg, we have to see him come alive here. And he's looking focused right now. And he has to know all eyes are on him. He has to know that... He had a bit of a wishy-washy performance in their second match of the day.
Look at that great effect where you can see the monitor in the SteelSeries headset. Somehow that, you know, it's almost like they planned it.
I just like how him and Forrest both have the Diablo SteelSeries, because both of these guys have actually played like an obscene amount of Diablo.
Who does that, man?
Who does that, really? Seriously.
Dude,
my Barbarian is so sick. Get on my level, Anders.
Oh, man. I think I've sunk like 3,000 hours into Diablo 3. It's not good.
Yeah, your mage, like, wow, man. All right, enough about that. Still, these guys definitely going to be focused. Exist actually has it as well, although I don't think he's played nearly as much Diablo, so bit of a poser there. All right, okay, let's see how things shape up. We are live with the match, and it looks like we've got the knife round sorted out as well, so NiP will be starting on the CT side here of this map, the deciding map.
To be honest, because of the map, I might have to change my prediction when it comes to like who's winning. I might have to switch back on Titan here.
I don't know.
NiP. Maybe that's a cowardly thing to do on the very last edge here. But I sort of feel like this is not my favorite map to watch NiP on. But Titan gonna go pretty aggressively out into the middle, jumping and shooting generally not a good idea. Akiok's gonna try it anyway, and they're very close to the mid doors here, or the B doors, sorry. Kaylee, Existence, and now they're gonna try and find Forrest, but he gets great headshots in return, and looking for a third one. Forrest knocking down Titan members left and right, and they control the bomb inside here. He's looking for a little bit more. They have a great crossfire right now, with Freiburg in the background, Forrest up close here. Still plenty of time for Titan to make a move if they want to, but they've got no kits anymore. They've got no grenades, sorry. All they have is themselves.
Yeah, they don't have a whole lot of HP as well. This is such a tricky position for Titan. That door is so, that bomb is so tantalizingly close to the doors. But in order to get to it, they have to walk into a NiP crossfire, and Forrest is holding so close, and Forrest, he's got three frags already. Is he going to get the ace? He manages to barely miss out on it. Freiburg is going to land that shot, and Forrest is not going to get the remaining two, but Freiburg picks up the two. Forrest with three, Freiburg with two, but that B defense holds solid, and that was crucial for NiP. They get the start they were looking for.
Wow, Forrest saving them right there. That was definitely really impressive. If he doesn't pick up those three kills, then there's no way. I mean, at the very least, Titan are going to be successful in putting down the bomb. And from there on out, it's kind of a short step to defending it afterwards, especially in a pistol round. That B bomb site's hard to retake.
Oh, it is. It is. You're walking into choke points wherever you go. And with NiP having such solid positions as well, that was a very tough position for Titan to be in. But Titan, they're not wasting any time. Because of a lack of plant in that pistol round, they don't hesitate to go for an armor buy here. So no helmets picked up for them, oddly enough. No helmets, but they're willing to go for Kevlar. They're going to get some nades. And only one CZ75 picked up on Kenny, which is kind of fitting, seeing as how he is the offer. And they seem to favor the pistol. Just ask JW. We'll see him later.
We definitely will. That's going to be exciting as hell. Oh, Exist flashed and smoked out quite a bit. They keep pushing up here, and this is, all right. They've done a little bit of damage. They do lose Kenny. More grenades raining in. Titan got to get closer if they want these pistols to really work fully.
Yeah, and look at Exist. He's getting into position right now to stop them if they were going to try and plant on the other side of the boxes there. So Titan, it seemed like the idea here was to smoke off Goose and try and get up close and go for that new bomb plant that you can go for that's facing Cat. But they never were allowed to get there. Exist, he had that little gap in the smoke to be able to stop them from getting close enough to be able to get that plant down. Exist living in that situation basically makes it for NiP. He stops Titan cold. And with the remaining members alive on long, NiP are able to hold and get a pretty solid anti-eco round in there. Four guys living is good enough here for NiP. And it's going to force Titan into a hard eco now, seeing as how Titan spent all of their money in that last round.
Yeah, and now, well, it's a really, really nice start for NiP here. Still conserving their money on Fifrion, as you can see. He's probably going to be buying an AWP later on. Mm-hmm. My worry is that I don't think Kenny's going to be able to pick up one here in the fourth round, will he? Unless he goes for straight glass cannon, but even then, I'm not sure he can.
No, he spent a lot of money last round.
Yeah.
He's not going to have it. He's going to have to go AK. I mean, everybody on Titan's going to have to go AK. I'd be amazed if they had the money to be able to go for any kind of AWP here on the French side. Or the French, Belgium, Swiss.
That's where it's at.
It's almost casual how Freiburg catches Badiak right there.
Okay. So a lot of nationalities, if you think about it, but not as many as Mousesports.
True. Mousesports is like five now?
Yeah.
This is crazy. All right, let's see. Freiburg looking for another. Trades up for Forrest's M4. And NiP right now is just looking pretty solid. Freiburg is going to hold this position very well here. Drops the bomb as well, so his teammates are going to be able to rotate in. Existence is trying to put up a bit of a fight mid, and he's going to do some good damage here. Drops Exist fairly low, down to around half HP.
It's almost like an excruciatingly slow round from Titan, considering they had just mainly Glocks in this round, right? It's sort of says a lot about how much they want to try and give themselves any opening they can, and they do actually get the kill there. Existence will go down, but maybe that slow play gave them a kill more than it should have been.
Yeah, that's the thing. Whatever, if you have a chance, take it. And Existence, he played that so well, just hiding behind the box and managing to focus on the man that he'd already damaged earlier on. And that's the important bit there. He just wanted to stay around and see if Existence was going to re-peek him and give him the opportunity to force NiP to spend more money in this round. So well played there by Existence. That's definitely Titan style. And now Titan are going to have enough money to go for a buy. But yeah, no AWP
for them. Double on the CT side, though. So that's the play NiP are going for, and that is not their usual style. Just to reiterate here, if you go back and look at all their NiP demos on this map, you'll find them maybe picking up a double up later in the game if they start losing, but never like this in the fourth round. That's very cool. They're just going straight for it. This is, I think, a power play against Titan. They're saying, you're not even going to get a foot down on this map. We'll shut you down before it even gets close.
Now, this is the scary situation. You're right. I mean, momentum has always been so crucial. Nice little molly there. The flash to follow, and Freiberg looking to take the fight. He's going to get an Apex. Not going to get anything more, though. Kenny shuts him down, but this is still a 2-on-4 situation. NiP in a fantastic position, but it's just going to be Forrest to hold here, and he actually gets out on the other side of the wall, and that's where he needs to be.
Interesting stuff coming out here. So they will probably try and get the bomb down here. Kenny could have lost his life peeking out, and he almost took down Forrest with him. Grenade to follow, won't really do anything. Kenny, once it plants, how are they going to hold it down? That's the big thing. Attempted spray through, but NiP should have a big advantage going into this 2-on-4.
Absolutely. Yeah, Kenny haven't taken so much damage. Kaylee still has he still has that molly, though, so he can chuck that down in the door or the window and try and buy some time, but Exist is going to overrun Kenny instantly, and Kaylee standing his ground. It's going to be Exist and Getright to clean things up. Exist with both of those frags on the retake, but NiP with four members living through that. This is just looking so good for the pajama-wearing ninjas.
Yeah, and Kenny asking for Forrest's health then. I think he was surprised and frustrated that Forrest didn't die.
Yeah, you can be sure about that. What I'm wondering right now, Titan, they're kind of dancing on the edge of a force buy. And I'm really curious to see if they're going to go for any kind of force here, because they just barely have enough, and yes, they are. So they do have reasonable nades on the guys who picked up Galil's, and then they have three AKs to work with here. But Titan, this is that decision, basically, where it's a comfort zone sort of thing. Do you want to give NiP another round and guarantee that you get the force, or that you get a buy with everything you need? And that's a confidence sort of thing right now. You've got to be really confident to make that call.
I think that's one way of looking at it. The other way of looking at it is, this is also Titan electing to have two rounds now without Kenny having an AWP. Mm-hmm. You gotta appreciate that is a concern for Titan. It always will be. It's not that Kenny's still a great rifler, but just a Galil or an AK, he's doing just fine. But it doesn't have the same impact as when he has an AWP.
Exactly,
and
we've
seen Titan a couple of times on Dust 2 kind of forget that fact for way too long.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't like this feels forced to me. This is that decision. And it's funny, it was actually with Shoxi that we had this discussion quite a bit at Gamescom, where it's like, are you willing to take it to the teeth? Take it in the teeth, basically. Take another round of the teeth just to make sure you have good money and just shut down the team after that. Or do you force early and take the risk? And right now, Titan are taking a risk, and the entry frag goes NiP's way. Oh. Great headshot there on a Kriplaren, though, to open up a slope, but Exist from Cross.
Yeah, boosted up on the, or just walked up on the burning car then. Very nicely done. Apex dropping very low, and he's going to get taken down by Getright. So nicely handled round from NiP. And
I don't like the Titan risk, and they certainly don't look happy right now. Maniac shaking his head. Apex, bit of the facepalm. Kaylee just looks focused at this point. Kaylee and Kenny, yeah, they aren't going to be the guys really talking for this team. It's going to come down a lot to Maniac, Existence, Apex kind of working out what they need to be doing.
This was some sexy move by him.
Exist. Yeah, that was really nice.
I'm going to be very upset if Titan don't go for at least one AWP here. They don't need a double AWP on the Terra side, but yeah. Kenny, I think that has to be the opening.
Mm-hmm.
Are they going to go for the smoke here?
They might try and sneak it. It's only Getright. He's only got an M4A1, so he needs to land some perfect shots and just spray control from him, but they do manage to sneak their way out eventually.
Yeah, when he comes back, and a grenade to follow as well, they will bring down Getright. It's not too bad, and another kill comes in, an assist. Pretty nicely done here from Apex, and Fuflaren missing a bit of a shot then, but don't think Apex should get much of a chance here to really do anything about it.
Well, the problem now is that Apex has picked up a rifle. He's got that AK, and he does actually some damage there. Freiberg is going to get the job done, but he drops down to 34 doing it. Fuflaren is going to be the man right now. He's 0-1-3. But he hasn't really had too much of an impact in this game, and he really hasn't been in position to have too much of an impact either.
They didn't go for the AWP. They didn't go for the AWP.
So they want the guaranteed two rounds of buy, basically. Like, that's what Titan have in mind right now.
I definitely disagree with this choice. I think this is a very bad move for the Titan team.
Well, it's what you wonder. It's like they've got two world-class offers. They've got Kenny and Kaylee. It's like, if you're not feeling confident in Kenny's play, well, then give the AWP to Kaylee. But
why would you not feel confident in Kenny's play? It's not like he's been missing a lot of shots today. He's been playing pretty well.
Well, he's been landing shots, but it's also been like, not the most important shots, but that's for another day because Kenny hits a running headshot on Force with that AK-47. And Exist is going to get overwhelmed as well. Freiburg is the only man alive here. Get right as well, but Freiburg is still alive on this V site. And this is so important. Apex is still wasting time trying to hunt him down. He's going to take the fight at range. And three kills come in for Titan. Just like that, Kaylee and Apex wrapping things up.
Very nicely done. A lot of speed on that round for Titan. It looked like it was going to crumble for a second, but they managed to readjust just in time. 6-1 moving into the 8th round, and let's see if it is going to happen. Yeah, this time they have it, and Kenny gets the long spawn as well, and this is great because NiP are running for it. This could be a free opening kill for Kenny. He's so good at this stuff. He does miss it just barely and eats a lot of grenade damage in return. So missed opportunity, but still, 60 health is plenty for an AWP like Kenny.
Yeah, he's going to be able to still land those shots. And that's just kind of the trade that you get right there. It's a real ballsy play to go for it as well, especially when you've got three guys barreling down on you with HEs. But Kenny actually doesn't get out of there, or he doesn't take too much damage in that exchange. So you can count himself a little lucky there. Smoke at the top of short, so Kenny just peeking to see if he can get any kind of opening there. But that smoke isn't really going to give him too much opportunity. It's going to be just Titan kind of spreading out back around this map. It looks like it will be an A split.
We'll have to find out. And actually, split, yeah, but the majority of the force down on long, so this is pretty interesting. I guess they have the AWP, so going long is makes sense in that direction. Get right's going to pick up the one kill here, but gets returned on by Kaylee. Some grenades flying down. Exist right now, not in a great spot, and this now in an even worse spot as Flaren goes down. He's going to take a quick peek. Yeah, now they know he's there. This is not going to work out well, I think, for the Swedish captain. Molotov there as well, and it's going to be Existence to pick it up. So in-game leader versus in-game leader, and the Belgian comes out on top. Now Freiburg down in CT spawn, trying to put some shots through, but can't quite connect, and NiP not looking good in this round.
No, it's not going to happen. They get pulled apart, essentially. They exist, unfortunately for him, timing, really. They don't manage to... Well... Exist the peak there. Had he peaked maybe like a second earlier, he would have been fine. He would have seen nobody, and well, Titan wouldn't have seen him. So maybe they go running by and he gets a couple frags. But them knowing exactly where he was allowed for Titan to adjust accordingly and make sure that they did not give him anything for free. And Fiflaren getting caught on the site like that, I mean, he was pinned down by Maniac working his way up on Cap. So, I mean, he gets caught behind the boxes, and that just opens it up as a free pick for Kenny.
Now let's see if NiP are able to put more rounds on the board here on the first half. The Titan have taken two in a row, and if NiP lose this upcoming round, I think they're going to have to echoing. They've bought a lot of AWPs already, so they got to be careful with that. Pop flash in, just checking, which is actually pretty good information from Titan. They haven't seen anyone, and that gives them a pretty good idea exactly where NiP are holding. They can guess that it's going to be one either in CT spawn or on the other side. But yeah, heavy mid emphasis from NiP, and Kenny, this is where he becomes sort of a tool on Titan for just getting entry frags, and that's what he's doing right now. You see, everyone else on Titan is sort of grouped up, but Kenny's the lone guy walking out. He does miss the shot on Fiflaren, who misses in turn, though.
Yeah, quick trade there. Forrest is going to sneak out into Upper Dark, though. That's going to wake Maniac up. Forrest looking for the click. He's not going to get it. He's trying to dance behind the pillar, but it's not going to work. It's going to be Freiburg to get that refrag, but the B defense is weakened here.
So is the A defense. They also lost Fiflaren, so this is actually a little bit of a tight spot here. And Apex runs into the bombsite just as Freiburg runs out. I'm not sure if he even heard him. He's going to check back in, and he sees him at the car, and Apex should come out on top of this. He's missing all the shots. What the hell? Now he's down to 5 health, and there's going to be a Molotov to follow. Up in the window, great grenade onto Exist. It's going to shut him down, and now in the middle, actually, Kaylee's coming up behind Freiburg to take him out, and Geraint has an AWP. And almost dies with it.
Oh, very close call there for Getright. He doesn't even have Kevlar right now, Getright. He's only got this AWP, trying to hold on to it as best he can, but they know exactly where he is, Titan, and they're not going to let him get out of this alive. Or at least they shouldn't. They should be hunting for him. The one worry here is that he managed to get down into pit, and that's what Kaylee's going to be trying to check right now. He's got to be worried about the angles that are going to be held. Getright, nobody's coming up on Cat. This is going to be awkward. He could just get completely outflanked. They've spotted him. They know where he is, and Kenny will find the shot at range. So Titan picking up a third round, and they're starting to get some momentum going their way. NiP are going to be forced to eco, and this is where it gets really awkward because look at how out of control the money is right now for Titan.
This is one of the best battles we've seen so far, just missing all the shots. Look how ridiculous this is.
How? That's like a cartoon, right? Where they just, you know, it's like a hail of bullets, and then you have the perfect outline of the guy.
That's basically what just happened. I mean, it's not like Freiburg were hitting a lot of shots either. They just both decided, or they just both couldn't hit any of the shots then. Apex gets an early kill on Freiburg, and I think, well, if Titan didn't guess it already, which they probably did, but now they definitely know that NiP are ecoing, so they put in a lot more speed here, feeling a lot more confident, I think, once they realize that.
Yeah, they can. They can move around this map. I mean, not to say that NiP aren't lethal even with the P2Ks. Steel Titan just kind of manhandling them at this point. Fifarn is the last man alive, trying to find a click on Kaylee. Kaylee's going to finish that up real quick with a two shot. So Titan are just, they're getting back into this, but look at what's really dangerous here now is that they have so much money on the T side. These rounds that they've managed to run back, and they've won them decisively as well, just means that now the money is starting to get a bit out of control, and NiP have a very long way ahead of them if they want to start getting some more rounds on the board. They're going to have to do it the hard way versus buy rounds.
Kaylee gets the long spawn, and well, Forrest has an ult, but he's not out here on long, so Kaylee's going to have a good chance. There's the one grenade and a Molotov is going to bring him down. Actually, not as far as I thought. He looked like he was going to take way more damage, but the interesting thing about Forrest is this ult that he has is actually a glass cannon. He's got no armor at all. He misses the first shot, and that brings him down to 17.
Tag through the door there. Fifflarn, however, will find Kaylee at long, so that's a good pick there for NiP. Entry frag is so important. Apex looking to see if anybody's going to be waiting in CT. Instead, it's going to be Fifflarn picking up his second frag. Existence gets cleared out of longhouse, and NiP are really throwing their weight around on the other side of the map.
This is really good news for the Swedish team, and something that they've been actually publicly talking about too, which is that, all right, we sometimes just give the ult to whoever we feel like. You know, whoever's feeling it. This round, apparently, is Forrest, who felt like, you know, let me get a shot at it. And Fifflarn, without the ult, he missed a couple of shots last round. Mm-hmm. So this time, he does with the M4 instead, and it gives him two kills. Very, very important decision-making from NiP. Now, Kenny going to be pushing up on short here with the rest of his team, and that's an absolutely mind-blowing shot. And Apex is going to take down Get Right. It was looking so good for NiP just 5 seconds ago, but now Titan are in a good position to win it. It's a 2-on-2 as Freiburg does take a kill, but now he's going to have to do it alone. It's not a bad player to have left Freiburg in a 1-on-2, but still.
Now, limited gear, though, and not too much time. He's had to run all the way over here from B. Maniac even has a Molly to burn even more time off this clock. Flash is going to go down. Freiburg just... he's getting close to the site, but Kenny, this bomb is planted for long, and Kenny is holding from long plateau, so this is about as good as it gets for Titan. A near impossible situation for Freiburg, and he walks right into the blender, so this is going to be NiP talking it over. I mean, if Fifflarn exists, they're all going to be sharing words about this, especially with PETA. Imagine the coaches right behind them trying to feed them info as to like what needs to happen here for them to get some control back. But yeah,
look,
that is
nonsense.
That's nonsense, you're right.
That is so absurd.
Kenny.
Oh, crossover shot not connecting. Well, NiP are back to ecoing, and Titan have a really good chance of equalizing the score, making it 6-6, at which point, you know, we've got to sort of take a step back and think about where we're actually at here. And even at 6-6, it's not so bad. It's not like NiP are suddenly really far behind. They've just been slowed down a pace or two.
Exactly. Exactly. I mean, it's still 6 rounds on the CT side. Once they swap over to the T side, NiP can still very well take this game. So it's very even right now. It's certainly Titan who've been fighting their way back. Great headshot there from Freiburg, and he's actually got Maniac pinned down around the corner. Maniac has to smoke himself off, and Freiburg looking for the shot. He's not going to get it. He's getting close, though. He's got that AK to work with now.
Yeah. That was just some great aim from Freiburg there. Fortunately, the rest of his team has kind of died, everyone except Fifflarn. And another sick headshot. Freiburg, what are you doing to this game?
He's waking up as well. This is it. He had a bit of a bumpy start to this tournament, but it looks like Freiburg, he's back in the mix. Kenny will hunt him down eventually, but the damage is done. Two kills from Freiburg is just fine there. They just need to be doing damage to Titan's economy because they have 4 guys who are above 16k right now. Or who are above 10k. Kenny S has $15,000 after full buying.
So, in other words, Titan are not going to be ecoing for the rest of this game. That's what it's down to. They have 4 Molotovs as well. There is the double up setup. Kenny comes out on top. Forrest trying for that peak and the flashbang as well to follow. Over on long, Fifflarn goes down. So, both the orbs gone within, what, 7 seconds of that round?
Pretty much. Yeah. Huge aggression coming out from Titan, managing to just pick them off. And that was just, it just looked like Kenny was so confident. Holding that angle. He's even looking here. Unscopes just as it goes by, but he still tags Freiburg through the door and drops him down to 22. NiP are really starting to focus more on this A area. Trying to control mid, basically. Existence is going to stop that nade from rolling in where it needs to.
Well, Get Ryan's picked up an open and actually picked up a kill as well. That's interesting. They need this round in IP. They really do need this round, and they can't get the shot on Kenny as he jumps down. There was a big opening for Freiburg, I think, who's stolen the other AWP. Maniac will take care of one of them, and that gives them the B bombsite no problem, and NiP should run away here.
Getright's got the AWP. He's already hightailing it over to Long, so he's going to want to get into pit as quickly as possible here. Just make sure that he can hold and exist. Same thing. There's no point in facing at this point. You're not going to force Titan to eco or anything if you get any kind of exit frags. It's much more important for NiP to just be backing off and holding onto these guns.
Okay, so it's been 6 rounds in a row here for Titan. So just try and get an idea about what NiP could do that they haven't been doing already, because they've been trying for their standard setup for quite a long time and it isn't working so well. So it might be time to switch it up, especially here in the last 2 rounds that are coming up. Mm-hmm. One of the things that you can do is maybe try and see if they can, instead of challenging Kenny in the middle, try and see if they can't take aggressive control of the lower and upper dark area. Smoke and flash their way through, put some people from B aggressively, get control of that part of the map. If not that, then why not go for the boost on short and then try and put one of the AWPs, right? They have Getright on it. So boost someone on short with an AWP, try and see if you can catch Titan off guard as they come through suicide. One of those things, that is, those are 2 strats that they haven't pulled yet, and try and see if it works. Because right now it feels like Titan are very much in control of what's going on here.
Yeah, they're dealing well with how predictable things are. And they go for an auto sniper buy in the 14th round. I'm wondering if they miscounted there. If they thought this was the 15th round.
What, Titan? Like,
yeah.
No, they just have so much money that they just don't give. They could just keep doing it.
Yeah. And it's not often that you have like 4 guys on 15K.
No.
So they're guaranteed to be able to buy in the next round regardless of what happens here. So it's not the end of the world, but Forest will win the duel in Upper Dark. Maniac has been picked off. Smoke is about to clear, though, so this could open things up for Apex to look for a refrag, but he's not going to have the opportunity to...
Question is, can Flaren over at the A-bomb side actually hold on to it with this AWP? Because Kenny is inching his way up there, and actually, no, he's going to fall back again, sorry. It looked like they were going to go for what they did in a couple of rounds ago where they used Kenny like that. Forest playing and waiting for... visual information from Freiburg, that's it. Mm-hmm. Teamwork being looked at right here. Apex, not so much teamwork, just kind of a lone assassin walking into the B bomb site. This is absolutely brilliant. He's going to be walking out, getting the one kill, and Forest goes down. Apex, single-handedly, that is impressive.
Yeah, and that's NiP putting way too much attention on mid. Not having a guy holding on site solid like that is it's a bit silly. I was wondering when it was going to bite them. But this time around, Titan just walking out full on ninja, managing to pick up those kills. And once again, Getright and Fifflaren in positions where they have to just be holding onto their guns. But Titan don't care. Titan are going to just try and hunt them. They know exactly what NiP are up to right now.
What's really interesting is that one really awkward duel that Freiburg was having with Apex was actually a result of the same thing, Apex just walking in. So it's not the first time he's had the chance to do it. Getright trying to stay alive here, and it's kind of like almost like when you were talking about Adrian on Mirage, just being able to walk out of the apartments. It sort of feels like Apex has just decided, I'm not going to flash and smoke or anything like that. I'm just going to get the kills.
Well, it's kind of NiP going all in right now. They're really focusing on shutting down a B split, and I'm not sure if it's really necessary for them to be focusing that hard. If they've got 2 guys, 1 in CT, 1 on slope, and maybe 1 holding from window, but not all the way out. Not in this position right here, because that's way too far out in the site. Like, you want to have Freiburg kind of floating in window, maybe going back in, back forth, or at the back of plateau. I mean, don't pull a guy off the site.
Maybe especially because in that round, they actually got the entry kill for Forest, so they already had a man up, right? They didn't need to take a big risk and leave the bomb site.
This is a basic tenet as well. If you have a man up, you never leave a site. Never do you leave a site, because that sort of thing can happen. They can sneak their way out onto a site. You're getting too giddy. You're getting too focused on one particular part of the map, and
but things actually are made. This round, things are looking good for NiP. If you flare and got them the entry frag over on long, Forest the follow-up kill. This is where NiP, it's, I don't want to say trivial, but this should be a very close to a solid round for NiP.
Well, this time around, we'll see. If Fifflaren is holding a good angle here from Goose to Cat. Goes for the pop, and he's not going to get it. He gets the leg instead. Existence is going to find Exist, however, and this is now going to be Fifflaren under a lot of pressure. He's going to get overwhelmed too quickly, just flashed into oblivion, and now we're into a 3-on-3 take on this A site. Titan are going to be able to get the plant, and they're going to be able to use the new bomb plant position.
Yeah, so now they just need to keep short control. They already have that great shot from Getright here, spraying down Maniac, and because Existence already so low, could be a 3-on-1 very soon here. The Belgian leader caught out in the middle of everything, and Kaylee wants to help him out, but that's just going to get him killed instead, and NiP will make it to that 7th round. The defuse comes in, good half is called, strange half more like. 6 rounds in a row for NiP, then another 8 rounds in a row straight for Titan, and finally NiP, they creep in with a round at the end. Mm-hmm. I think overall, both teams have a really good shot of doing this. It's nobody's game to take right now. No, it's just kind of pretty even.
You're right, man. It is. Because really, Titan could start off strong with the pistol. And then we could see them do what NiP did to them in this first half. They could run away and take six rounds. They could definitely run away and just close the whole game out with the strong CT side. So Titan are not a team to be taken lightly, whichever side they're on.
I think Titan have a much greater chance of playing a strong CT side than NiP do. Because while the double up setup sort of works for NiP, and it does, like Forrest is a really good AWPer. If Flaren on Dust 2 especially can definitely make it work. We saw it right here. I mean, he played a really good first half. But I think Titan have an edge, right? Kenny and Kaylee, they're slightly different caliber.
It's actually stupidly scary because you can put them wherever you want and look at this Apex. He wants to play aggressive. He puts that nade up into suicide, but it's not going to be there. And look at Titan. They're immediately going for some cool boosts. This one to look over this smoke that's blocking off the doors. Look up to short. So if Fifloren goes running up here and he's not paying attention, he's going to get picked off easy.
Flash bangs himself in, and that's going to be an instant headshot. Fifloren forcing his way through. That's a great opening pick. Goes for a second one here, but he gets team flashed, in fact, and he's still going to pick it up. A nice double kill in the pistol round as well. Fifloren worth his weight in gold right here. He's going to pick up a third one because why not? Existence, the last one alive, gets knifed by Forrest, down on long, stabbed to death. And NiP win the pistol round convincingly, thanks to Fifloren. That was huge.
Oh, wow, yeah. That entry frag, I mean, the flash into doors. All right, he flashes his way in, so the NOA stack actually can't stop him. And then he insta-gibs Kaylee like that on Cat. That couldn't have gone better for Fifloren. A triple kill for him in the pistol round, and that opens everything up wide here. NiP now in a fantastic position to get some momentum going early on in this T-half. They are on the favored side of Dust2, after all.
They are, but Titan have armor and a pistol as well on Kenny. He's got no armor, which is good news. That means this time Titan have, you know, they've remembered, oh, wait a minute, we have this guy and he's pretty good with an orb, so we should buy one on him later. And Existence has a scout. I like this buy from Titan. I think this is a good idea, and they are, historically anyway, Titan organization has been really good at picking up these second rounds.
Yes, they have. They were the guys that were feared. They were like the anti-eco or the, you know, the second round masters, basically. You know, it might as well be a buy round because they're spending everything they've got, but these Titan were feared for a very long time in these sorts of situations, and they have clever plays like that as well. Existence actually getting boosted, but then jumping, because with the scout, he's still accurate. So he's looking all the way up mid over that smoke for a shot. No opportunity until Forrest decides to shoot Apex in the face.
He's down to three as well. Apex is going to be upset about that one. Kaylee looking for a headshot on somebody. He's not going to connect with it, so Exist just driving it into the A bomb site, and it's going to be Kenny and Existence left on the other side of the map. Saving a scout's not a bad idea. Saving this P250, I don't know. I'd rather him looking for a kill, and he's actually set up for it as well.
Yeah. He's going to be able to pick up Fifloren here. No, not a whole lot the Fifloren could do, but he was alone, and now he's given a gun over to Kenny, but to Titan, and that's actually a bit risky. Tag goes out, they're going to manage to overwhelm Existence, who was holding on the B site, and now they're going to come and hunt Kenny. Thing is that NiP can't really afford to give away too many guns here. Giving away this AK was already a big mistake, and Kenny could potentially pick up another one, but Freiburg will save it, and he's going to be able to save that gun too. So that was a great recovery there by NiP, but it was definitely a bit of a risky situation, because if Kenny makes it out of there with that AK and gets kills to boot, that's actually NiP kind of throwing away all the advantage they got out of that round.
Yeah, got to be careful with that stuff. Titan, they're around behind here. They've lost the lead, but once they combine, not in this round, but in the upcoming round, could change really quickly. But NiP have a good chance of taking a two-round lead here, and that in itself is going to feel pretty great. Remember, whoever loses this match is out second in the groups. They are not going to be going to play at the Global tomorrow, and I don't know. I mean, we saw the pictures with NiP. They already have fans behind them, even when they're playing at the LAN Center.
Yeah.
So at the stadium, you gotta expect there's going to be a lot of people waiting for NiP over there.
Yeah, and you guys, I mean, if you're tuning in from Stockholm or somewhere around here in the area, they're playing up in Inferno Online in Odenplan. So the big Inferno, you guys can go and watch everything happen there, because we have another group coming up after this. So it's going to be CS all day and all night over there.
Yes. Fnatic, Dignitas, Copenhagen Wolves, and 3D Max are playing in the next group. And that's going to be an explosive group as well. Oh, yeah. Very exciting games, without a doubt. Forrest, good opening onto Apex here. There's a nice headshot. Again, Forrest just with the pistol. He's playing that scouting role, being put in as the guy in front. You can see he's almost body blocking Freiburg here. Just taking the bullets. Shoot me.
He wants to serve as the bait, right? And they're taking a fight at range. Forrest just trying to find that shot. He's got to get the headshot eventually on Kaylee. Plant goes down now. for Cat, and that's going to open things up here. I mean, it doesn't really put Titan in any kind of position where they can win the round. They're just looking to see if they can't pick up any kind of damage here versus NiP, but it's not happening. Maniac is looking for the headshot, but Freiburg finds it at range, and that's going to be a perfect round for NiP. And that's exactly what they need, because these guys, whoa, that kid looks sick behind them. Did you see that look at the camera? He was just like, what's up, NiP? Yeah, they're good. They're the best in the world. You better recognize, son.
That's really cute as well. I love that. Like, he can't be that old, but already out there supporting.
Damn straight, that jersey behind. All right. Back to the point, though. NiP, this is good for their money. This is good for everything here. If they can take this first hurdle, the 19th round, they're looking very good to pick up this map.
Well, yeah, and Fifrion actually went for a... No, so that was that Forrest? Went in for a blind peek over at Long, but he got flashed, couldn't see a thing, didn't get the kill. Kenny has an AWP on the other team, and that's good news. It's actually Glass Cannon, but I don't really mind that. I don't think that's going to make such a big deal, especially not when he's at the back of the B1 side like he is right now, because that's a tough spot to grenade up against an AWPer. Mm-hmm. You can throw grenades that far if you keep running a little bit, but chances are you're going to lose your life to it.
Yeah, it's scary. It's definitely scary. Running in straight lines is ill-advised when you have hoppers like Kenny on the map.
Without a doubt. Well, NiP are gearing up for a split push towards the A-bomb side. Actually, I'm not a fan of Titan's setup right here because they have the one guy down on long, but with that kind of opening frag, that's doing a lot right here. Apex taking down Freiburg, and now NiP, they're backing up? They don't feel like it.
Seems like they're much more interested in going for the B side at this point. A B split push could work out nicely. They've got the smoke down to block off CT, but Kenny is here with the AWP, and he picks Get Right immediately.
Yeah, nicely done. Exist has made his way through, going to smoke off again. Now they're all going to A instead, so Exist is just faking it here while the rest of NiP are going for the A bomb site, but Titan are not moving. They're just standing their ground. Almost nobody from Titan moved that whole round. They just had their original positions. Grenade can't even catch Apex, and Kaylee comes in with a headshot. It's a flawless round for Titan, and mm-hmm. that has to feel good for them.
Yeah, and you can see just how tough it is for NiP when they can't find that entry frag. After that, it just seems to be a little bit of hesitation coming into their play, not really sure where they want to go with it, especially once Kenny picks off Get Right over on the B site. Those guys who are waiting in mid, it's just three of them, but to go onto B when you have both guys holding solid from the site is near suicide, even with three guys. And going over to A, everybody's still there for Titan, so NiP not really sure where to go once they lose that guy.
I mean, NiP couldn't really know. I mean, we knew because we had the overview, but the setup that Titan had last time around, if NiP had actually gone for A and smoked off down towards long, that would have been a really effective move there, even with the opening pick that Apex, the Maniac got. Anyway, this round starts off with a great shot onto Kenny S, but the boost, the Noah Tower, down in that down towards CT spawn actually works out pretty well.
The timing doesn't work out. They're trying to spray through the smoke as well, but they're going to get out of here. Scott free Titan, nade to chase him along, and Existence takes 7 damage. That's still a very nice opening from Titan to actually bring it back to a 4-on-4. They're very clever with these boosts, Titan. It's good to see them actually work out because we don't get to see enough boosts, really, I think. It's very cool to see it when on the CT side they can actually manage them. But it looks like NiP are definitely going to be going for a bit of an A play here. They're going to put a little bit of attention here on Cat. Forrest leading the way with that AWP, looking to create the opportunity. If he can find this entry, they can speed up right behind it.
Yeah, and again, one guy basically holding here. The gun down on Pit's not going to be able to help out Maniac, so a few grenades and maybe a few HC grenades down on ramp there, and it's going to be working out pretty well. Maniac's going to take the peak. There's one grenade raining in. Good timing for Maniac. Does some good damage, but Exist somehow comes out on top. The Molotovs will follow, but not going to get a kill with it. Get Right goes down, though.
Yeah, Get Right getting picked off of Cat is not going to help things here. Apex almost gets the jumping shot with the M4A1. He's looking for these bombsite players. Exist is down so low, down to 15 HP, and Forrest has been dropped as well. A mad spray from Apex, and he does it in the end. 3-on-2 situation, and Forrest is out in the open. Apex is just laying waste.
Oh, and the bomb plant position is awful for NiP, and that's because of the Molotov that was thrown down earlier. Such a small incident, but such a huge consequence here for NiP. If they could have planted on the other side of the boxes, then they would have been able to save that plant and defend it for a long time. But the initial Molotov that almost killed Exist forced them to plant on the other side, and that made all the difference in the world. At the time when it happened, that one Molotov seemed completely insignificant. It seemed like it had no impact in the game at all. But in the after plant position, it had a huge impact. And now Titan have tied the other way. It's 10-10. NiP can still buy, but they must be running out of money as well.
Yeah, they've definitely got to be scraping the bottom of the barrel here. Look at that. They're limited on nades, so they've really put everything they have into this round. If they lose it, Titan are going to be looking very good indeed. But again, NiP are just coming back to sets to basics. But look at what Titan are doing. They're going to go for a bit of something to change it up here. This could potentially catch Get Right off guard. Get Right is looking to see if anybody's going to be trying pushing from upper dark, and he's going to get the shot onto Kenny, but he doesn't get the job done.
Nope. They take almost exactly the same amount of damage here. So I think that's still actually going to favor Titan, just because Kenny can easily fall back. Apex did receive a lot of damage too, so he's down to 55. That's a bigger problem, I think, right now for Titan. They're looking for the opening. Forest with the AWP is going to be Molotov back. There's still three mollies left on Titan's side.
Yeah, that's an amazing amount of time right there. And it can slow down Nip's momentum so drastically. That's the thing here. So Nip right now, 10-10 the score. Even, no entry frag yet, but Nip are running out of time. 35 seconds left. Fifflarin is going to be sneaking in through Longhouse. Not sure if Kaylee spotted him there. Don't think Kaylee knows that Fifflarin is so close right now. He's going to go walking in, looks for the confirmation. Fifflarin goes for the spray, but he doesn't get it. And Maniac, in the meantime, has stopped the cat push.
Yeah, and Apex delayed it even further with that one Molotov. Existence still has his in hand, and now it's a 2-on-5 here. Exist missing a shot, and Titan taking this round with ease. That's a triple kill for Maniac, and 11-10. Titan making this work right here. They're really making a comeback happen, and NiP are going to have to eco.
NiP definitely have to eco at this point. No bomb plant either to help them along the way. And if we could bring up the stats real quick just to see how things have developed as far as the rounds are concerned. So let's take off the scoreboard and bring up the stats. Yeah, awesome. Yeah, so it's just been 3-3 basically right from the start. Kenny S has managed to pick up rounds. This is just an anti-eco round coming in here right now from Titan, so they should be able to take this fairly cleanly and build up that money that they've got already. It's going to help them quite a bit, and it's just a slaughter at mid. So very quick work there by Titan, but now 12 rounds. They need 4 to pick it up and guarantee a spot tomorrow in the semis.
NiP, I can't believe it. This game is so close, and it must be scary for them being in this situation. They're going to go for all AKs. They could have gone for Glass Cannon AWP. I don't really mind that they didn't, but I'm hoping that they will then play accordingly to this AK buy. And something like a V-split push or a very aggressive rush like this out on long, that's exactly what he used this AK buy for. Exist rushing through the smoke, just going to catch one. Could have got two. He's going to put it for the second one, and Maniac's not going to die. 6 health on him left, but up on short. Forest is coming in, and Get Right's going to pick off where Exist left off, and now Freiburg looking for the spray. He's going to take down Apex and a Molotov to keep them out. Now they can put the bomb down finally.
Well, they can. Get Right gets across the gap. No spray in there from Titan. They're just trying to change up their positions. Nice little molly there to stop the bomb site plant at least. And Kenny S is looking for the wraparound. Is Freiburg going to be ready? Freiburg turns away, and there's the AWP shot from Kenny. 1v2 clutch situation now from Get Right.
He has to come up big here. They got to win this round. Otherwise, Titan are very close to just running away with this game. They have got the kits. They've got no more grenades left on Titan. So one opening frag here for Get Right, and all of a sudden it's a 1-on-1. Titan trying to time it perfectly. Get Right comes in, sprays down one, and almost gets it, but not quite. Kenny a little bit too fast with the C-set 75, and it's going to be the defuse happening. Titan claiming another round. Very close. Very scary game, this one for both teams.
This is so tense. They get that bomb plant, though, so NiP should have enough money to force in this round. Despite the fact that they spent everything in the last, they're getting good bonus money, and there you go. Yeah, Forest has the glass cannon off. So they decide to go back to the AWP here, despite how much trouble they've been having with it. NiP, Forest just putting a random shot through, trying to time the jump, but he's not going to get it.
No, I think he was trying to time the peak, in fact, and Apex just going nuts. It wasn't just on the A bombs, or so on the B bomb side, on the terrorist side, that he's sneaking in. He's just being given free reins to just go in crazy.
But this is one of Titan's strategies that we've been seeing them use on Dust2 as well. For them to wait now to start using this, an ultra-aggressive strat that we've seen them use in the past. The mind games right now coming out from Existence, the leader for Titan, they're sick.
Trying to flash themselves in here. Kenny going to make the crossover, and then a little bit of backup from Existence there if anything was going to go wrong. Exist going to peek in here. Goes for Kenny. Almost gets the shot down, and then they're going to fall back. Actually, not a bad idea for NiP. Good chance Kenny could have picked up that kill if they kept pushing.
Yeah, Kaylee is alive at the back of Plateau on B site, though. Get Right is just clicking away once again. Maniac taught him not to do that. And Forest, he doesn't get that shot. He has to get it now. Get Right is going to look for Existence, and that's the B site down to Kaylee. This is the defense here, but Forest can't seem to land the shot.
And there it is. And I think Forrest actually would have had to... Oh, in the middle, Exist picks up 2 headshots. Apex and Kenny walked up. They must have lined up perfectly. And that is a genius position here. The Swedish captain definitely has some tricks of his own. And now, well, Maniac in a one-on-two here. That settled everything. NiP were still going to be in a tough position getting into that bomb site if Exist hadn't picked up those two kills. That was huge. Now the bomb is down. And they just have to try and see if they can take down Maniac. Yeah.
Give up one guy, sure. Sack one guy if they can just hold on to the other. But Maniac lands a perfect headshot on Forrest, predicts it, and he knows that the other man is going to be in upper dark. He looks away from Getright, but turns around in time. But he's running out of time. He doesn't actually have time to stop this bomb. Getright just runs away straight away, and there it is. Not enough time for the defuse. Getright knew exactly what was happening, and he even saves the AWP for Forrest.
That initial kill for Maniac was terrifying. There was one detail that was a little bit of a shame there, which is that Maniac actually had a Molotov, and he could have put it straight into upper. I guess he didn't exactly know if Getright was going to be upper or behind headshot box, or the big box going into mm-hmm. plateau, so that's maybe what caused him to hesitate. But he actually had the tools to do that one-on-two. Oh god, NiP are still very close to losing this. It's 11-13 right now. Titan are playing very well. You got to consider this is a brand new lineup. They've had minimal time to perfect all of this, and it's still looking really cool.
Playing against the oldest lineup in CSGO right now, 2 years and running for NiP.
Yeah.
So this is definitely the old veterans up against the young bucks, in a sense, just because of the age of the lineups here. Not the case with the players on them. But still, Titan right now, they're just 3 rounds away. They still have money, and they have money for another buy in the next round, I think. So they should be all right here in this sort of position. If they give away a couple rounds to NiP, it's not the end of the world. Whereas NiP, they are allowed to make no mistakes.
Existence, playing a fun game. I'm wondering what he's doing with the smoke here.
Oh. He's going to smoke it off from them. Remember this?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
He's going to smoke it off. He's waiting to see if anybody comes in through mid-doors right now, and then he's going to throw that smoke, block off the doors, and they're just going to choke him out. They're going to run straight into upper dark.
Yeah.
If this happens, Existence is going to smoke and run straight into upper dark and annihilate that side of the push
from
NiP.
You're exactly right. And this is just when the lineup was made that we discovered that this is something they like doing. So he sees them there, smokes in, turns around, he's ready for the upper push. And actually, Getright somehow sprays down Kenny, but Existence is still here, picks up the one, gets the second one, and then he's gonna fall. He wasn't as committed to upper as he normally is, you're right, but still, NiP not out of this round yet. 4 seconds as the plant goes down. Maniac with a good headshot here. Flashbang rains in. Forrest will pick up one. It's still a 2-on-2. They gotta keep going. And sorry, that was Exist with that kill. Gets a second 1-2. Now Maniac. It's a 1-on-1 at Forrest. With the Galil, picks up the shot, saves the AWP, and it's closer still. What a great match this is. Back and forth all the time. Titan, I think they're still going to have enough money to buy.
They will. They will have enough money. Let's make sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, Existence is... this is just fantastic from Existence, though. Still managing to pick up 2 frags from that position is just great work from him. He set it up for his team, but they couldn't quite do it. It's going to be Forrest picking up Apex in the end.
With the help from Kenny.
Yeah, with the help of Kenny.
Some team damage, and they've got a double up set up here, which means Titan has invested a huge amount of money into this round. If we bring up the scoreboard real quick, how much money have they got on Titan
now?
They
have zero now.
Nothing at all. But NiP don't either. The whole game could turn on this one round here. If Titan win it, they're not just going to bounce to 14. They're very likely going to bounce to 15 rounds. Mm-hmm. And that's match and map point.
But if NiP win it, they go straight up to 14. Titan may be in a position where they actually have to double eco or go for an awkward force. They could run it right up to 15 themselves. So NiP, so much pressure on this one round. This could be the one round that decides the entire map right here. And so far, 4v4, very patient play from NiP. They're occupying very passive positions to make sure that Titan can't push out anywhere. They don't want to get caught off guard by anything at all. Maniac holding at Longhouse. This could be an opportunity for him. Fifflarin, Freiburg both here. Freiburg with an 8 in hand. The timing! And Fifflarin, he will get the refrag.
That's really critical. Maniac has been playing really well today as well, but not quite good enough to take down both. Now, Kaylee's over here, and that's an easy shot on Forrest, bringing it to a 2-on-3. That's one of the problems. The really big problem is they have no time left. At all. I have no idea how NiP is going to try and win this. Fiflarin with a sick headshot. He has to check the corner though. Kaylee's right in there and it should be an easy kill for Kaylee to pick up. He's waiting. He does it. And that is the end of the round. Exist can't do a thing anymore. Even if he gets this kill, it's not going to be enough. But Kaylee stays alive. Triple. And that's 14 rounds for Titan.
And now Titan, they've just got to keep their composure. Existence looks so focused right now. Everybody on Titan. They've got to know that they're just on the very brink of knocking out a favorite to make it into the finals. The last Counter-Strike Global Offensive Major Championship title holder is NiP. If they were out of this LAN, it'd be a massive upset, no matter which team did it. This is now Titan on the brink, and it's a hard eco here from NiP. They've just spent a couple of dollars on the P250s, 900 bucks, with a couple of nades to follow. But this is very much going to be a full YOLO push, it seems. They're gathering up in Upper Dark. There's one man to hold, and that's Existence. As soon as this smoke clears, they may try and put some pressure here, NiP.
They're going to fight for overtime.
Incredible.
Which is not, it's not that far out of reach for NiP. Because, again, Titan's money, even if they win this round flawlessly, it's not going to be so good that they can just buy the rest of the game.
True.
If NiP string together a couple of rounds, then they're home free, but what a scary situation here for the Swedish ninjas.
Absolutely terrible. And this is a struggle. Existence will cut it down. Exist Kenny S at the doors. They've rotated back in time from B Slope to be able to stop this push. The crossfire is established, and Freiburg and Get Right are the last man alive here. But the bomb is dropped in the middle of no land, no man's land, and Get Right, he's not going to get too much done here. It's just Freiburg now alive. Apex on the hunt, but it's going to be Maniac setting up that frag and match and map point here for Titan.
Oh, showing, I mean, you've got to consider, again, this is just the, you know, the entry level for Titan right here. Because once they've been playing together for a couple of months, this lineup's going to do a lot more. There's no doubt about that. And already it's looking really good. I mean, they lost to LDLC earlier today. It was a close game, but they couldn't make it through. Right now, they're taking revenge on NiP instead.
I bet they are.
And the Swedes, they have four Galils and one AK, a couple of smokes as well. It could be done. It could definitely be done. The boost is up in the middle again. And NiP, they already lost a couple of members to this earlier. Forest peeking out here. It's going to get the one. Could have been the double. Apex falling down mid-air gets the kill. Freiburg wants to peek up behind this and almost catches Apex. How is he still alive?
So close. The Molly goes down, but that's not going to help too much. Get Right has snuck his way out onto the B site, however. And Titan, tut tut, don't leave a site unattended.
Yeah, this is what... This is what happened to them, what Apex did to them in the first game, or the first half, but now Get Right is in here. They're going to be able to actually peek in. Kenny's up in the window. They got to keep an eye on Kenny, and he sneaks in, gets the kill on Exist. He's so fast. Now Kaylee's next in line. They're just taking turns to peek in through that window. Molotov goes in. Bomb will be planted here. It's a 3-on-4. NiP have to keep this one alive. Otherwise, they're going to be out. They won't make it to the main part of this tournament over at the Ericsson Globe. Flaren in Upper Dark. Two people coming for him. He's going to have to stand strong here. Goes for the first one. Maniac taking some damage. Flaren picks up one and a second headshot. Now it's going to be Kaylee coming in with the kill on Freiburg here. And he's in the back of the site. It's still a 2-on-2. That bomb is ticking away. And Get Right is just hiding. He's so close. They have no idea. He sweeps around. Gets the one kill. Now Kaylee alive in a 1-on-2. And behind this box, it's Get Right to seal it. Get Right and Flaren. What a great tag team. And they do win the round one step closer. But Titan will still have money. The French team can still do this, but this is so ridiculously close. What a match.
I'm having flashbacks to Gamescom Final when Fiflaren won that round on short with the triple spray that broke Fnatic's economy. He was the key position there for NiP. Holding Upper Dark like that did not let Titan go for that pincer movement that would just have crushed Get Right outright on that B site. So Fiflaren with the double spray makes it happen. Freiburg, quick entry out onto Long. And this is, I mean, it's a gathering on the other side, the wrong side of the map for Titan.
They are utterly out of position here on the CT side. They're going to get to the bomb site in time to retake it, sure, but they won't have that many grenades or anything. They have a Molotov just used now and Exist here waiting in a good spot. It's going to catch Kaylee. He did get a return kill. It's still 2-on-2 here. And now it's a 2-on-1. If they win this round, it's almost certainly going to be overtime. Kenny has the bomb, and that's the one crucial fact here. Looking for it. Gonna get the one kill, and there comes Exist.
Oh, no! Kenny,
what are you kidding me? He picks up the kill, and look at that. The excitement. Titan take out NiP. What a sick performance from Kenny. They should be carrying him on their shoulders right now. That was magnificent. Absolutely love it. Oh, I wish we could have audio. I wish we were already in the Ericsson Globe, just so we can hear the crowd right there.
I'm speechless. Kenny, we have to watch this shot again. I mean,
that is incredible. Absolutely incredible.
That was it, though. That was so crucial that the bomb dropped down to Kenny and that NiP had to go after him. To do one shot, pick the man off Cat, okay. But for NiP not to land the spray on Kenny in that position when he's holding from element, high ground advantage, everything should have been for NiP. And Kenny somehow lands the shot. Incredible. Just incredible. Oh. That is why Kenny is one of the best offers in the world. He is capable of those sorts of situations.
Yeah. Yeah, that there's just at some point where talent comes into play, right? You could train a lot of people to op, you know, 80% of the way to what Kenny does, but the last 20% you have to kind of be Kenny to do that or someone like that. Very few people in the world could do that. That's absolutely crazy. What a game. All right, so it's the two French teams, LDLC and Titan, make it out of the first group, and NiP and Alternate don't.
Yeah, I'm just
exciting times.
But it comes down to that. NiP was so close to running it back, and we go into overtime, the whole shebang. But Titan, they actually get the win. But now the real question is, what happens with NiP? They're out of a group stage on home turf at DreamHack, not making it into the playoffs. It's a huge defeat for them.
NiP,
the only way they're going to look at it they're going to look at it as a huge defeat. So
yeah,
we'll have to keep our eyes peeled.
It is a huge defeat.
It is. LDLC Titan, though.
You know what we're going to need? They're going to need revenge.
Is it going to be the return of El Clasico?
Yeah, think about that, guys. We're going to go to a quick commercial break before we go come back with the second group, which features Fnatic.
Oh, we have a one-hour break, apparently.
One-hour break
before the next, because I'm guessing the teams need to set up, warm up, all that jazz.
Well, we could use a bit of break too, so that's cool. It's Dignitas, Fnatic, Copenhagen Wolves, and 3D Max from Finland. So don't go away, guys. One-hour break, and we'll be back soon. So, get something to eat, get something to drink, and we'll be back right here on the channel.